baptism, our gracious Heavenly Father, liberates us from sin and death by joining us in the death and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. We're born children of a fallen humanity, but in the waters of baptism we're reborn, children of God and inheritors of human life. By water and the Holy Spirit we're made members of the church which is the body of Christ, his community, his people, and grow in faith, love, and obedience to the Lord God. Now I ask the godparents to present. Christian love, you presented this child for holy baptism. You should therefore faithfully bring him to service as God's house, teaching the Lord's Prayer, the Creed, and the Ten Commandments. As she grows in years, you should place in her hands the Holy Scriptures and provide for her instruction in Christian faith. That living in the covenant of her baptism and in communion with the Church, she would lead a godly life until the day of Jesus Christ. Do you promise to fulfill these obligations? And now I ask you to profess your faith in Christ Jesus, reject sin, and profess the faith of the Church, the faith in which we baptize. You renounce all the forces of evil, the devil, and all his empty promises. And now I ask you, with the congregation assembled, do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord.
He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in God the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit. The Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Okay, so are we ready? And we have a small few on the better view. Genevieve Grace, I baptize you in the name of God, and of the Son, that's way too bold. God the Father, our Lord Jesus Christ, we give you thanks for freeing this daughter from the power of sin and raising her up to new life through this holy sacrament. For your Holy Spirit, I give you grace, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, and the Spirit of joy in your presence. Amen. Give you grace, child of God, you can seal the Holy Spirit. God has come into Jimmy's life for the purpose that the light of Christ would shine through her. As Jesus said, let your light so shine before others that they will see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven. Let's pray. God, the giver of all life, look with kindness upon the Father and Mother and the grandparents of this child. Let them always rejoice in the gift you've given them. Make them teachers and examples of righteousness for their child. Strengthen them in their own baptism so that they will share eternity with their child the salvation we give them through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please rise. Through baptism, God has made this new sister a member of the priesthood that we share in Christ Jesus, that we can proclaim the praise of God and bear his creative and redeeming word to all the world. We welcome you into the Lord's family.
fellow members of the body of Christ, a child of the same Heavenly Father, and a worker with us in the kingdom of God.
Through baptism, God has made peace with Genevieve, cleansing her from sin and restoring her to a new relationship with Him. And He offers that same new start to us. So with confidence, I can say, may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Greet each other.